said, you know, Super Lake likes to keep that distance and throw that leg kick. And already you've seen Daniel closing a distance, so trending that boxing move, really work his game.
5 3-minute rounds in this world title fight. The belt has been vacated, so these two ranked inside the top five. The winner walks out of Bangkok with the belt.
Yeah, you know, you see him Superlek right now establishing the jab and throwing more punches. He talked about that this week, that in his camp he was working on his hands a lot more this time so that he had more tools to bring to the fight.
You already seen Daniel trying to close that distance, trying to not stay in that kicking lane. Already a good overhand right. Just really focus on closing that distance. That gives him an opportunity to set up that leg kick.
Time! Stop!
Okay. It's really important that Daniel throws different weapons at him, not the same thing over and over. He kind of gets in the habit of throwing hand combinations and a low kick. You don't really want to give Superlek a lot of chances to get reads on you. So you have to mix things up and keep things different.
So that backward motion from Superlek that I was talking about before, just slight step backwards right there, where his kick completely misses.
Huertas firing shots to the body here. 1 minute into the first round of five.
Daniel's doing a good job in closing that distance over and over. I'd love to see him close the distance and try to get off angle instead of walking right in there.
Hard right and a nice outside leg kick from Superlek. And then another right and another kick.
This is that defense where Huertas shells up that I'm talking about. See him just there, nice slip off of that, came back with a counter, it didn't land. But that's better than him shelling up because Superlek is able to tee off on him.
And that's what Daniel wants. He wants to have Superlek against the cage where he can actually tee off and get his combinations going. There's always people pushing him there, just trying to smother that range. So he's not going to eat those leg kicks.
Huertas using the push kick there. Outside, and Superlek. High with that one, a little low, however you want to look at it. Legs and got him in the groin.
I like the way Superlek's also throwing that knee. He's throwing it as Daniel starts to come forward and sets up. He's going to start catching with that knee as he's coming in. He's got to be careful closing that distance that quick because that knee is coming up with some velocity.
That's why he's got to, when he closes that distance, he's got to get off angle to miss that knee, right? You know, Superlek is, you know, he's got his timing down, and each time he crosses that distance, he's just throwing a knee, and Daniel's running right into it.
Superlek, lightning quick, hit round one, and then a big knee.
I'll tell you what, Huertas better come up with an answer for those leg kicks as well, because Superlek is starting to chew that left leg of his up. You can see the welting on the hamstring of the left leg right now starting to form.
Stop, stop, separate, separate.
Final 20 seconds, round one.
Yeah, we'll see who.
Not holding here, not holding. Yeah? Listen to stuff, right?
We'll see who makes the adjustments going into the second round, right? Typically, the ties, you know, first round's kind of just reading your opponent, and then the second round, they start to make their adjustments, and they go off and roll.
Downloading the information and then they make those updates.
But I think Daniel's pressure starting to get to Superlek. You know, I think the last 10 seconds there, I think Superlek was looking a little bit, you know, wow, this guy's not going to stop. He's going to keep coming. These leg kicks aren't adding up. Usually they slow down after 10.
Yeah, I agree with you. You know, Superlek does such a good job of mitigating the closing of the distance coming in that Huertas has given him fits.
One fight night, 7 February. We are right back in Bangkok. Lineker and Andrade 2 cannot wait in a little over a month. The second event of 2023, historic Lumpini Boxing Stadium.
I know, I'm excited to have a strikers like this, like Fabricio Andrade and Lineker in Lumpini Stadium. Oh, I'm sending shivers down my body thinking about that.
Inside the corner of Superlek, round two of five in this world title fight. The flyweight kickboxing division here in one championship.
All right, let's see if Dan's gonna continue that board pressure. And he is.
What's the boxing from Huertas? I like him mixing up those body shots, getting into his range, and then those low kicks. He's gotta lean on his strengths. He doesn't wanna play the kicking game with Superlek.
He goes, in that boxing range.
Overhand right from Huertas.
Superleg kind of uses that push kick as like a moat, right? It's like a defensive force field that kind of keeps him around him just to keep his opponents away from him.
Yeah, because obviously Superleg wants to have that distance that way he can get that kick in range going on. I think he's getting a little more flustered from Daniel closing that distance and trying to get the outside.
Body kick landed from Superleg. Top now and then the knee.
Those two combinations right there were landing because Barrantes was standing in that no man's land right in that range where Superleg can fire, and he's just kind of shelled up, not doing anything. He needs either to be in or he needs to be out.
You just need the leg right there.
1 minute into round two of this world title fight.
He's just trying to put the pressure on him, right? Sometimes you got to do that when you're going against a guy who has potentially better striking than you and a great leg kick. So you got to shut that distance down and just put him in that, make it a fight, right? Because it's a five-round fight. It's a world title fight. So maybe in the fourth round, Daniel pushing the pace and closing the distance, probably going to pay dividends and be able to have his way.
He's got to make it ugly. He's got to make it dirty. He doesn't want to play that Muay Thai classic striking game. He doesn't want to give that space, make things nasty.
Absolutely.
Midway through round two. Puertas with a jab.
Ooh, nice uppercut.
The uppercut. Taken to the body, Puertas.
I feel the pressure starting. It's gonna pay off for him, right? Like he's sticking to the game plan. Obviously, also cross distance, getting Superleg space, and see how he's gonna, you know, respond to that. And right here, you know, Superleg's not bouncing up, taking angles. He's continuing to walk him back and keep throwing the shots, the knees, and the high kick.
Hook to the body again from Puertas. He changes levels, trying to go over the top here. Final minute, second round.
Once again, crossing that distance, just trying to get in his face. Right there, that's a good shot, body shot. He's just got to make sure when he gets to that angle, if Superleg covers up, he's got to get off angle. He's got to get behind that shoulder and start letting some punches go. Don't stand in front of him because that's why that knee keeps on landing right there every single time.
Yeah, it's very difficult to get Superleg out of position. Once you actually get him out of position, you cut that corner or something, have that angle. You have to take advantage of that.
It's a five-round fight, right? So what kind of difference do you think it's going to put in those later rounds if it does get there? Because Puertas hasn't been five rounds since 2018.
Well, it seems like he came prepared because his condition doesn't seem slowing down right now, and he's continuing to push the pace. So I feel he's used to this pressure. I feel he's committed to this game plan for the crossing distance and staying in front.
See what, I think that right hand just hurt Superleg, and Superleg looked up to check the clock, and that's typically not a good sign when a fighter does that.
Nope. I think the pressure is getting to him. I think Daniel is committed to crossing distance, staying on him, making it an ugly fight, not letting, you know, Superleg get his game going. And I think in the fourth and fifth round, you're going to see huge dividends pay off.
Well, I'll tell you, if Puertas is able to pull this off in rounds 3, 4, and 5 here.
What's he doing well here, Rich? What are you seeing? I like the shell. You were talking this about the shell, and he's deflecting a lot of shots.
This is that forward pressure that I was talking about. Puertas is coming in and putting Superleg back on the cage.
When he's coming close to you, continue boxing. Just go for it. Strong.
The trainer said, continue your boxing. Keep going for it. Keep pressuring. And that's what we're seeing. We're seeing Daniel keep him going, keep going and crossing the distance, not letting Superleg get his game going.
Habla Espanol?
Poquito.
Yes. Yes. Round three.
Already.
Flyweight kickboxing world championship.
Now, we've seen some huge upsets when it comes to these world titles. I mean, we saw, you know, Joseph Lasiri come out of nowhere and really make a huge impact, you know, by putting the pressure on these guys, not backing down, not being scared of their records and their reputations.
Well, when I just saw here, the ref just dinged Superleg for grabbing a clinch. You know, a lot of people gotta understand when it's kickboxing, you can't clinch. You only throw one knee when you clinch. And if you go back to the Hiro Akimoto versus One Punch Man, Hiro Akimoto did a good job of just crossing distance over and over and over and trying. They're changing.
This is the first time that we've seen Superleg moving forward. And he talked about working his hands in camp. Maybe this is the switch of direction that he needs, is actually put the pressure on Daniel Puertas, not doing that typical step back that he does. He's unloading here on the fence. Puertas is hurt.
Under siege.
He's got to move. He's got to circle. He's got to get out of there. Circle and move. And, you know, that knee almost knocked on that. Right at the chin.
Good head movement. He's got to move. Get his back off the wall.
Puertas taking heavy artillery in the opening minute of the third round. Big right, big knee.
by Puertas. He's keeping it in.
He's doing a good job of covering himself and not taking a lot of damage either between the slips.
He's got to get his back off that cage. He's got to get his back off the cage.
Yeah, you don't want to play rope-a-dope with super high kick.
No, especially with him, the way he's been throwing knees all fight. No, you don't want to do that.
How do you do it, DJ? How do you get out of there?
So you got to circle. You use your footwork, you know. But, you know, Daniel can, you know, use this to his advantage. You know, super leg seems pretty spent with this, right? And once again, when the ties, they get tired, they want to clinch, right? And the ref keeps on breaking them up. So hopefully Daniel can just move off angle and be able to get something going.
Head kick from super leg, and then another knee. And another.
Daniel doesn't quite have his feet underneath him. I think he's wobbled a little bit. He needs to move, regain his senses. Not firefight right now.
He's still there. He's still there. He's trying to, he's trying to bang. He's trying to make this a real fight.
Look how wobbly he looks. Look at him.
Hey, this is all part of the game plan, all right? Don't you worry.
Uppercut from Puertas. He continues to fire strikes back.
But see, the ref keeps breaking him up because Super League wants that, close that distance for the clinch. And the ref keeps breaking him, says you cannot clinch.
You can see Puertas' footwork has changed here. He's really starting to widen his stance, dig into the ground, and he's looking for that one big punch.
Here we go. See, now, ooh, that was a low blow again.
But he doesn't need that big punch. He's got to move. He's got to stick and move. Go back to what got him here so far. Keep that jab out there. Keep throwing those leg kicks.
Now it's coming out to who's in better condition, right? Super leg just unloaded, you know, probably a 25, you know, combination, and still pushing forward, trying to change the narrative of the fight of him going forward instead of him backing up.
Again, Puertas back against the fence.
He was originally supposed to fight Boateng, so he was only preparing for 3 rounds. Last minute, Inahachi drops out. He gets his shot at the gold, and you know, that changes a lot.
Yeah, I don't think preparing for 3 rounds over 5 rounds is that much of a difference. It's just having the intelligence to run a different pace in the fight.
No, and you see that big deep breath Super Leg just took a huge deep breath. And, you know, with Daniel, he was supposed to, I believe, face Rotting, correct? So Rotting has that forward pressure. So I'm sure his conditioning was built to get ready for Rotting.
Look at this. This is what we're talking about. Daniel Puertas closing that distance, throwing those hands, looking for a home for his hands. And he's doing a good job of truly understanding the distance, but this is when Superleg started to unload. And there was a big right hand that wobbled Puertas. That was the one right there. Look at him. Good job of using the fence to stay upright.
Yeah, he was actually razor close, in my opinion, of possibly getting a standing eight count here because it wasn't responding to anything initially. And I thought that the referee was going to step in for a moment.
Don't lean forward too much.
Oh, here we go.
Okay.
Round four. So let's see if this pressure is going to pay dividends. He's been going forward the whole fight, besides the last round, where Super League was really pushing forward to try to change the narrative of the fight. Gotta close that distance and stop eating those leg kicks. Close that distance, get on him, put the pressure on him.
This is that range I was talking about before, where Puertas is standing right there in the mid range, where Super League is just throwing those kicks. Coming in, get in, tight on the inside, throw the combinations and get back out.
Yep, absolutely.
Nice uppercut.
Shots from Puertas, head kick from Superleg.
There's that nice box from Daniel. Now here is corner scene. Keep crossing distance. When you get to that distance, let your box and go. Light him up. And that's where Daniel wants to be, right there. Put Superleg trying to decide what is he going to do. Where he wants to clinch. He wants that clinch. Right? He wants that clinch to stop Daniel's pressure. Right there. This is where Daniel wants to be, right there. He's got to get there, get off angle, let five punches go, and then.
Stop!
This is the head movement you're talking about. He slipped off the line with that punch there, came back to the body with the shovel hook.
Daniel's got a lot of kicks on that arm. I asked him about that. I was like, how are you going to deal with those kicks? He's like, dude, I got arms of of spear. He's going to take it and come right back with an answer. And he's staying true to his word.
Yep. And see, like I said before, this is what you see. You saw it when One Punch fought Hiroaki Goto. He always kept closing a distance in the kickboxing match. He wants to hold because he's not used to this pressure and conditioning. Right? So right now, I'm sure Superlek's going to get dinged a point because he's been reminded over and over and over again, you cannot clinch. This is kickboxing, not Muay Thai.
The voice there of the one flyweight world champion, Demetrius Johnson, with a circle side. The rest of the night. Great to have you with us, DJ, ahead of your massive fight in America in early May.
Hey, it feels good. It feels good to be here and to try to share some of my knowledge surface out with you gentlemen. And I think Daniel's got to keep that pressure there because he can't, Superlek cannot break that habit of this right here, of closing the distance. He wants to hold.
Elias may take, the referee might take a point away if this keeps happening with this clinch. You know, you're not allowed to clinch under kickboxing rules.
I think Daniel's doing a good job of forcing him to clinch because he's not, right here, once again, he doesn't like that pressure. Right? Daniel is just trying to force the action and get there to where he's comfortable. Where Superlek needs that distance, he wants to be able to throw, right? So just keep crossing that distance and force him to clinch. Maybe the ref can take a point.
What's the difference between clinching and like tying up like you do in boxing, right? I mean, he's not actually clinching looking for the clinch from a
Muay Thai standpoint.
Exactly, yeah. But you're not supposed to use the clinch defensively either by the rule set here in kickboxing world championship.
Yeah, and you've seen, you know, Super, he's always initiating that clinch. He's always initiating the grab. And I think Superlek's using it in order to stop Daniel's, you know, arsenal. Because when he gets in this range, I believe Daniel is winning the fight.
Curtis, heavy shots to close out the round, even with the blood trickling down the left side of his eye.
So we're four deep.
Who
do you have ahead on the scorecards right now?
Man, it's very hard. You know, obviously, I'm really liking the pressure that Daniel is putting on Superlek. But I don't know how the judges are gonna score the leg kicks.
You just kick them, just kick him. Yeah, just punch him, punch his leg, kick him.
You have to use your knees and box and box and box. Come on, let's go.
Man, Brent, I'm starting to wonder if Superlek underestimated Mr. Puertas.
You know, may have.
I didn't know. I didn't think we would be here. Right? Honestly, I'm surprised we're here in the fifth and final.
Listen, I'm not going to let DJ Mitch out on me like that. So who do you have ahead on the scorecards after four?
You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and go with even. 2-2. 2-2.
He Mitched out. That was a Chilson.
So the fifth and perhaps deciding round in this world title fight.
Well, it's hard because you don't know what's being more damaging. You know, I love how Daniel's really causing pressure. And once again, he keeps on.
Oh, wow. So at least the lapses here was breaking them apart. The fighters have to obey the commands. We've had several of these incidents right here. He may actually issue a yellow card on this because the clinch. Puertas punched him after the break.
But it could have been for the clinch.
I think it's for the clinch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, it's for the clinch.
It's not a late shot. He's going into the pocket.
There go 10%.
Oh. Yellow card. Superlek.
See, I said it. I was like, oh, referee might take a point because of the clinching. Whether it was a tie-up or a clinch, can't do it.
Yep.
Gotta have that space.
Yep. If I was Daniel, I'll run at him. Just run full speed at him. Grab me, please.
Here he comes again. Curtis on the offensive. Head kick go from Superlek on the way out. Another one from Superlek.
This right here is Daniel Curtis going to take it. He needs to take advantage of it.
Yep. Once again, boom, there's a clinch every single time. And Daniel's got to close that distance. He can't stay in that kicking range where Superlek can just keep throwing those high kicks.
Yeah. Superlek has responded since being issued the yellow card.
Puertas had a nice lean back right there, made Superlek miss. That's what he should be doing this entire match.
2 minutes to go in this world title fight.
Yeah, it's very hard to see who's scoring and who's up and who's down.
This is a good little kicking defense from Puertas with his lean backs.
See right there, if I was Superlek, I would have let go and did a five-piece combination, not use that clinch in order to stop the fight. But see, he's... Uh-oh. Now he's getting Daniel to clinch.
Huertas digging in with that left hook. Defensive again. For the body and then the low kick. Fires a right hook and a left is Huertas. And there's the big right to the face of Superleg.
He's closing that distance right there. He's got to go. See, now that Superleg is ducking his head, each time he gets to that distance, he's got to get off angle. I've been seeing it all night. Get off angle. I want to cross that distance.
Head kick from Superleg and then to the body.
See, but Daniel's now found an answer for it. He might take a kick, but he's throwing the little leg kicks. There's always an answer for Huertas, and I like that in this round. And he's got the yellow card.
There we go, right there. Push him off. You got to get him offline and hit him. Hit him with the right hand. Once he clinches, well, he's not clinching anymore. He's just ducking his head in there once he gets that distance.
You know, Mitch, you mentioned the yellow card, and that's going to affect the score of this round, I'm sure. But keep in mind that this is a 10-point must system fight. This isn't judged in its entirety, so it's only going to help him out in this round, so to speak. This is all going to depend on how the judges have the earlier rounds of this match score.
Pretend judge over there had it 2-2, Mr. DJ. So that could be it.
I'm professional, okay? I you know, as I'm watching it, like I said, I don't know how the judge is going to score it when Superleg throws a high kick and Daniel blocks it with his glove. Like, you know, how is that scored, right? I mean, it looks bad, but, you know, he is blocking it. Now here's Superleg going forward.
But normally we can see a little bit of reddening on the back of Daniel's shoulder, but not too much. So that's not really going to count in one of our highest scoring categories, which is damage, Rich. So how are they scoring these when he's taking them all in the arm?
But see, go ahead, sorry. But now you're seeing Superleg in the last 10 seconds use a clinch. He threw three knees in the clinch, right? So that's one of the things when you see these ties go to kickboxing is that when they start getting tired, they want to clinch.
You see it in those last clinches quite a bit, but it was throughout the match that when Elias Dolopsis is trying to break them apart, Superleg's just hanging onto that clinch as long as he possibly can, chewing time off the clock.
Yep. Strategy. You know, it's literally a strategy. And I've seen this done before, and it's very hard to break that rhythm or that habit from guys who come from a Muay Thai background is stopping them from clinching. When you have somebody who's going to close distance on you, they're going to try to clinch. And we saw a lot of that from Daniel. So great fight from both these guys.
Well, we were treated to an outstanding matchup in this co-main event here in Bangkok tonight. Back and forth stuff for the flyweight kickboxing world title. Second-ranked Superleg and fifth-ranked Spaniard Daniel Huertas. And for the official decision, here's Tom Lau.
This match was presented to you by Tumi. And now to present the belt for this match, we have the chairman and CEO of ONE Championship, Mr. Chatri Siddhukong. Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision and new undisputed flyweight kickboxing champion of the world, Superleg!